Hey Knights, welcome back to another episode of The Studio. On today's show, we check out a healthy drink shop in downtown Gilbert, sit down with a Higley father who has a passion for music, and spend some more time with Mrs. Bird, who recently shifted roles from an English teacher to a dean of students. A brand new episode of The Studio starts right now.
Hey guys.
I don't want to go to school tomorrow, I can study thinking about you. I don't want to go to sleep tonight when I can stay up thinking about you. And you know I always do. Marlboro Nights. Marlboro Nights.
Hey Knights, I'm Sophia Riggs. Making New Year's resolutions is a popular tradition where people set personal goals to make positive change in their lives. Sean and Hayden hit the courtyard to find out what resolutions Higley students are making in their 2021.
With 2021, a lot of Knights are saying New Year, New Me. But we went around Higley to see what these Knights are doing to meet their New Year's resolutions. What are some of your New Year's resolutions?
To get a girlfriend.
What are you gonna do to get a girlfriend?
Be myself and be a nice person.
Do you think it'll work?
We'll see.
What are some of your New Year's resolutions?
I'm trying to find a job.
Where are you trying to find a job at?
Anywhere that isn't Popeyes.
Do you have any New Year's resolutions?
Yes, it was to stop drinking soda.
What are you gonna do to meet those New Year's resolutions?
Not drink soda.
I just wanna get big. I wanna get swole. You know, you're a big guy. I'm trying to get big like you, Hate.
How are you gonna try to get big?
Going to the gym, eating right.
Sure. Pass my 10th grade year.
What are you gonna do to pass your 10th grade year?
Probably just cheat on all my assignments so I can pass.
Are you gonna move to online school so you can do that?
No.
No? Why not?
Parents won't let me.
Well, there you have it, Knights. We have a lot of work to do in 2021 to meet our New Year's resolutions. Happy New Year. This has been Hayden Forwalk signing out for The Studio.
Listen up, Knights. I've got a question for you. Are you sick of going to the same three drink places around here? Or possibly looking for a more healthy option? Well, there's a local drink shop on the rise called Vibe that has a bunch of delicious and healthy choices we think you'd love. Sophia and Kaylee have the story.
Vibe is a drink and snack shop in downtown Gilbert that specializes in providing healthy and nutritious alternatives for your everyday energy drinks and shakes.
I would describe Vibe as a healthy, happy hangout. One of the reasons we opened Vibe is we wanted a quick, healthy option for people to come in. I would say we have a huge demographic range because whatever is popular on social media, obviously we have the younger influence, but then we have a lot of the older demographic that tends to care more about their health.
So I found Vibe on Instagram and I thought they were really cute and I had to check it out. And they're just as friendly in person as they are on Instagram.
One of the reasons we like to separate ourselves apart first and foremost from any other business is the customer service. We're huge on people's names, knowing people's names. Our intention is not to just serve them a drink and send them on their way. We actually care about our customers, what's going on. And if we could help them in any other way outside of just serving them a beverage, you know, just a conversation for the day, that's really the goal.
The customer service is super great. And they're super friendly and they really make you feel at home.
Our teas are definitely what we're most known for, I feel like, on our social media account.
The teas are really good. My favorite tea to get is the cucumber watermelon because it's super refreshing and it's just the perfect amount of sweetness. They've got stuff for anybody. You can get small drinks, big drinks, and really it's just a place to come and hang out.
My favorite part about working here is the environment. Reason being is our name is a play on words, right? So we always say your vibe attracts your tribe, and we like to have a fun environment that I would want to be around all day.
Although Vibe is a thriving business now, it took a long journey to make Vibe what it is today.
Opening our shop was something that we had planned for a long time in the making. We worked from home for 9 years doing this exact same thing. So we had a full plan of what we're gonna do, how we're gonna do it. I thought about it and I actually built this place. When I was growing up and I was into sports and I was looking for what was healthy and different things, I created a business around that. I feel like we attract a really fun crowd and it's a pleasure to be here every day. So I'd say if you like cool drinks, fun atmosphere, good people, then come check us out.
Make sure to check out Vibe on Instagram at Vibe_Gilbert for updates on new drinks and exclusive offers, as well as stopping in to support this blossoming local business. This is Sophia and Kaylee signing off from The Studio. Juniors, PSATs are coming up next Tuesday. Make sure to get a good night's sleep and come prepared. If you're registered to take it, make sure to arrive on campus around 7 to 7:15. Anyone not testing is expected to go to their first hour at noon.
Be sure to stop by the Armory during lunch today. They've got a ton of new items to check out, such as scrunchies, lanyards, and more included with all their delicious drinks and snacks. Help support your fellow Knights.
Graphic design is an elective course on campus where students prepare for a career in graphic arts. Using the Adobe apps, Illustrator, and Photoshop, they work to meet the graphic needs of the campus by creating purposeful designs that can be used in a variety of ways. Caden and Connor caught up with Mr. Lebsock to find more about this exciting career preparation program.
The graphic design class is an elective you can take here at Higley that allows students to learn about creating graphics for businesses and providing real-world skills. Mr. Lebsock, the teacher of this class, had a bit more to say about this course.
The graphic design program is focused on being a current technical education program that allows students to explore through hands-on education the graphic design career pathway. So we do a variety of things from photography to print medium to even developing the Excalibur, which is the Higley High School yearbook. And we always try and focus it more on being client-based so that they get that hands-on experience and they know how to be a leader with 21st century skills in today's workforce. The things that the graphic design program has done for the school and the school district is pretty wide-ranging. It's been pretty impressive to see how the program has grown just based on the quality work the students are producing. Last year we were able to create A banners when the school rankings were released, so we created one of those for each school. And then the students got to go and present them to the district principals. And this year we've been helping with various projects with Wellness Month, from the selfie boards that went out to all the schools. We've produced a communication board to help the special education students at Chaparral. And it's just been a variety of projects. Some of the future plans for the graphic design program is to continue to expand the hands-on opportunities within the program. We are very fortunate that we just recently updated the lab, where we have a full functioning photography studio, a basically small print shop where we have a large scale printer that can print banners, as well as a copier that can do small runs of programs. And so it's just finding more and more opportunities. We are fortunate that we have a positive reputation within the district, but there's a lot of opportunities to grow and develop skills that, even if you're not necessarily interested in the graphic design career, it will benefit you because it will make you marketable and a value asset to whatever company you work for.
If you consider yourself to be creative, artistic, and you're looking for real-world skills in one class, sign up for graphic design.
On Tuesday, the girls' soccer team went head-to-head with Paradise Valley and cruised to victory with a final score of 8-0. Next week, the girls look to start the season 2-0 as they head to Gilbert High to take on the Tigers.
Just a friendly reminder to clean up after you finish your lunch. Do your part and lend a hand to our hard-working janitors. Help stop the spread of COVID-19 by keeping your space clean.
This year, one of our English teachers, Miss Bird, took on a new position as Dean of Students. Vanessa and Christelle checked in with her to learn more about this shift in her career and the responsibilities that come with being an administrator.
Mrs. Bird, a former English teacher, recently got accepted into administration as the Dean of Students, so we checked in to ask her about this new opportunity.
As Dean of Students, I'm responsible for student discipline, and I also evaluate a couple of our departments. I'm involved right now with doing some professional development courses for teachers and help teachers out with Canvas and tech support and that kind of thing. They were looking for new deans. This is something, it's a position that started at Sossaman, and then they opened it up to the high school. So it was a new position that came open last year, and it just happened to coincide right when I finished my master's degree. So I actually never thought about going into administration when I was in teaching, but you know, once you get into something and you learn things and you kind of grow and realize that you're ready for a new challenge, so.
While Mrs. Bird enjoys her new job, she initially had difficulties getting into the habit of her daily routine.
The shift from the teaching into administration, it's definitely a different focus. I had to come in and kind of get my footing here, and I had to kind of figure out what is my role on this team, and being in the classroom for so long has actually helped me do better in this job because I can support teachers because I was just there. My focus now is maybe a little more on teachers and helping them to support students versus me supporting students directly.
With this new position, Mrs. Bird brings up what she loves most about being the Dean of Students.
Just the friendships that you build and just knowing that you're making a difference in people's lives, not just in students' lives, but in teachers' lives. And, you know, it's just that I've been here for 16 years, so I really feel part of this family. I just feel like I don't know that it was so much an inspiration to go into teaching, but just this is what I'm here for. Wherever this path takes me, I'll go. I don't really have any expectations that we'll see. We'll see what happens next.
This has been Christelle and Vanessa. Peace out.
A local rapper and Higley father going by the name of Pete Thero has been running a family-owned clothing company for almost 5 years. Mikey and Eric found time to visit his home in Gilbert to learn more about his business and life experiences.
Pete Thero is a rapper, small business owner, and father to one of our very own Higley Knights. Throughout his career, he has focused on inspiring others to make a better life for themselves. Inspired by many iconic rappers, Pete Thero is devoted in creating a positive change through his music and his company, Foundation.
Foundation has been around for about 4 years now. So kind of tinkered with it in the beginning phases, and then these last couple years, it's been more serious. Just kind of looking at some different colorways, some different brands, tampering into some different markets. So we get in there. Now I'm touching every piece at this point, I'm touching every single piece. I get with my manufacturers, I'm touching the clothing to make sure that we're using high quality. I don't like things that's gonna shrink on you or you can just rip off like Hulk Hogan. It has to be something that's gonna last a long time, that feels good, hugs you in the right spots, but loose on the other spots, you know what I'm saying? So I'm touching every single piece just to make sure that things are coming across good, it lasts a long time, and hopefully you come back. It really actually kind of started with like the music, to be frankly honest. I was shooting this Moonwalker video and I just needed some stuff to wear. So it started with the FOE shield. I don't have one on me, but it started with that, and I kind of did it for myself. And everybody was asking like, yo, where can I get one of those? Where can I get one of those? And before you know it, I was like, well, I'll do you one, just give me the money and so on and so forth. And then that just kind of spun into me just looking around and seeing other brands and seeing what the kids was wearing. There wasn't a lot of positive stuff going on, and a lot of the positive brands that talk about something, they're corny, to be frankly honest. Just not something cool. So I was like, I could put something together. It means something. It represents something. Going after whatever it is that you want to do with your life, and we're going to make it look good and look cool, and it'll start with me. And that's how it came about.
Foundation offers a wide selection of products, including beanies and hoodies and everything in between.
Go right to foundnation.co. So it's not a .com, it's just found, F-O-U-N-D, nation.co. It'll take you right to the site, get everything you need, or you can go to any social media platform, but if you Google it, I'll pop up.
Knights, if you're interested in rap or looking for new clothes, be sure to check out Pete Thero and his company Foundation at foundnation.co. This is Mikey and Eric reporting for the studio.
Next week is the first Food Truck Friday of 2021. Don't forget to bring your money so you can grab lunch from one of these delicious food and drink vendors. The East Valley Institute of Technology, also known as EVIT, is an educational campus offering programs in a variety of career and technical education fields. Sydney and Lucy track down a few Knights who attend EVIT each day as they prepare for a career in cosmetology.
As the second semester begins, it's time to start thinking about your schedule for next year. Future juniors and seniors may consider joining EVIT. This week, we talked to some students in the cosmetology program to see what it's all about.
Your first year, you learn basically everything, like all the skills that you need in order to get your license. You learn it all.
Second year is more preparing for state board testing so that you can get your license and kind of perfecting all those skills before you go out in the field. So we're graded both for written work and practical work. Written work would be more like tests, vocab, kind of things like that, whereas practical, where you're working on either a client or a mannequin or a partner and kind of actually practicing the skills you're learning about.
When you graduate, you have a choice between a hairstylist license and a cosmetologist license. The difference is the amount of hours, so I will be doing hairstylist because it's only 1,400 hours compared to 1,600.
EVIT gives students the chance to go above and beyond and graduate high school with more than just their diploma.
Since I'm in EVIT, I'll be able to graduate high school with my cosmetology license, which I'll be able to get a job right after high school, a job that pays really well, and I don't have to go to college if I don't want to, since I'll have something that sets me up for my future.
It'll help my future from when I get my license and want to work in a salon, I'll be able to because I have the credentials. I would recommend it because if you're interested in doing hair, it's worth a shot, and it's way cheaper than doing it out of high school and when you're graduated.
I love EVIT mostly because I'm not sitting down all day, and EVIT is super hands-on, and you kind of get to focus on what you're really interested in, so I like it for that.
If you're interested in joining EVIT next year, see Mr. Boyea in the counselor's office or email him at walter.boyea@husd.org. Registrations are happening right now, so do it as soon as possible. This has been Sydney and Lucy reporting for The Studio.
That's all I've got for you this week, Knights. Remember to stay safe and have a wonderful weekend. We'll see you next week.